a very happy Easter. Welcome to this online traditional service as we celebrate the greatest event in history, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. During this morning service, we'll be having communion, so do please be prepared for that with your own bread and your own wine or juice. So we continue in worship by saying our opening prayer. Lord of all life and power, who through the mighty resurrection of your Son overcame the old order of sin and death to make all things new in him, grant that we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, may reign with him in glory, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be praise and honour, glory and might, now and in all eternity. Amen. Jesus Christ, risen Master and triumphant Lord, we come to you in sorrow for our sins and confess to you our weakness and unbelief. We have lived by our own strength and not by the power of your resurrection. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. We have lived by the light of our own eyes as faithless and not believing. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. We have lived for this world alone and doubted our home in heaven. In your mercy, forgive us. Lord, hear us and help us. So let everything be said and done in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God through Jesus Christ. Sing psalms, hymns, and sacred songs. Open our lips, Lord, and we shall praise your name.
Crown him with many crowns. A reading from Acts. Then Peter began to speak. I now realise how true it is that God does not show favouritism, but accept men from every nation who fear him and do what is right. You know the message God sent to the people of Israel, telling the good news of peace through Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. You know what has happened throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, and how he went around doing good and healing all who were under the power of the devil, because God was with him. We are witnesses of everything he did in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They killed him by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him from the dead on the third day and caused him to be seen. He was not seen by all the people, but by witnesses whom God had already chosen, by us who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one whom God appointed as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. And a reading from the Gospel of Matthew. After the Sabbath, at dawn on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven and, going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. The angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you're looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here. He is risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples. He is risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you." So the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them. "Greetings," he said. They came to him, clasped his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me."
Well, happy Easter. Now, even in the middle of a global pandemic, when so many people have suffered loneliness, anxiety, loss, hardship, darkness of many sorts, we can still say happy Easter. Why? Well, it's because Easter is the ultimate expression of hope. Easter says things like loneliness, anxiety, hardship, sadness, fear, hate, all those things don't last forever. On Good Friday, the followers of Jesus had just seen him crucified on a cross. Their hopes seemingly dashed. All they could see was defeat. No hope for the future. Then on the first Easter day that we heard Louise read to us, some women arrived at the tomb to anoint Jesus' dead body. They found the tomb was empty. An angel told them that Jesus had risen. And it says, so the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy. On that first Easter morning, their sadness turned to joy. On the evening of that first Easter day, the other disciples were gathered in a room with the doors locked, and it says for fear of the Jews. Then the risen Jesus appeared to them and said, "Peace be with you." He imparted peace to their frightened hearts. Their fear turned to peace. A while later, the Apostle Paul, who at first hated the early Christians, he used to persecute them, have them thrown into prison because they were claiming that Jesus had risen from the dead. Then the risen Jesus appeared to him on a road to Damascus, and his hate was turned to love. His life was transformed. 20 years later, he wrote, "The Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me." See, Easter turns our sadness into joy, our fears into peace, and our hate into love. And it says these things don't last forever. Over this past year, over 126,000 people have died from coronavirus. That's a lot of people. That's a lot of sadness, it's a lot of grief, which we should do. We should grieve our losses. Many people have the question, what happens when I die? It's an important question. There was a headline in a satirical magazine that read, "World death rate holding steady at 100%. Death affects us all. And when you go to a funeral and the coffin goes into the ground, it looks final. And it is, unless death has been conquered. Easter says we can have hope even in the face of death. You know, Jesus' body was raised to life. He had a resurrected body. He ate fish. Says in 1 Thessalonians 4, "Brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be ignorant about those who sleep, or to grieve like the rest who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again. And so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in him. The dead in Christ will rise first, after that we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words." Death is not the end. God will raise us to new life, to live with him eternally. That is eternal life. That is the gift that Jesus offers to us. You know, Easter says, your future is secure. And it's the ultimate expression of hope. The resurrection confirms that what Jesus did on the cross worked. You know, on the cross, all our sin, all our guilt, and all our shame was dealt with. It was all laid upon Jesus. He took on himself the sin of the world. He took all my sin and all your sin, all my guilt and all your guilt, all my shame and all your shame. He took it upon himself in our place. And Easter says the cross was effective. It really did do what it set out to do. We really now are free to have relationship with Father God. We really are free to love him and serve him. You know, I used to be a skeptic when it comes to Christianity. And then over 30 years ago, I experienced the risen Jesus. And it transformed my life. Millions of people since that first Easter day will also say they've experienced the risen Jesus. People from all walks of life, from all nations, from all tribal groups, the rich, the poor, the educated, the uneducated. You know, the resurrection of Jesus isn't just a fanciful idea or cleverly invented myth. It is based on historical evidence. Evidence you can examine yourself. Easter means that our lives can be transformed because Jesus is alive. Sadness can be turned to joy. Fear can be turned to peace. Hate can be turned to love. Despair can be turned to hope. There's a great painting done by Holman Hunt called The Light of the World. And it shows Jesus outside a door knocking. And the scene is an overgrown garden. And the scene depicts someone's life with Jesus knocking on the door, waiting to be invited in. And he's saying, "Here I am. I stand at the door and knock. If anyone opens the door, I will come in and eat with them and they with me." In other words, Jesus is saying, "I want to come and be part of your life." In the painting, there's no handle on the outside of the door. And someone pointed this out to Holman Hunt, saying, "Well, it must be a mistake. There's no handle on the outside." And Holman Hunt replied and said, "No, it's not a mistake. There's only one handle, and that's on the inside of the door." See, Jesus doesn't force himself into anyone's life. He loves us too much and respects our freedom too much. He leaves us free to decide or not to open the door to him. Maybe you've never invited Jesus into your life. Maybe you used to know him, but your faith has just grown cold over the years. But you want to come home. Well, you know, the Father longs for you to come home. If you'd like to, then on this Easter Sunday, take the opportunity to invite Jesus into your life, because he is standing at the door, knocking, waiting to be invited to come in. And if you want to do that, then here is a prayer to let you do that. Just say, "Lord Jesus Christ, I'm sorry for the things I have done wrong in my life." And take a few moments to ask his forgiveness for anything that is on your conscience. "Please forgive me. And I now turn from everything which I know is wrong. Thank you that you died on the cross for me, so that I could be forgiven and set free. Thank you that you offer me forgiveness, eternal life, and the gift of your Spirit. And I now receive your Holy Spirit. Please come into my life by your Holy Spirit to be with me forever. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen." And I want to pray for you, if you just prayed that prayer, that you would experience the Spirit of God, the Spirit of Jesus, which he pours into our hearts. It's an experience of the love of God. So Holy Spirit, would you draw close? Would you make yourself known, the risen Jesus? Would you reassure people of the love you have for them, of your longing for relationship? Amen. If you have just prayed that prayer, I'd like to invite you to our Alpha course. Actually, even if you didn't pray that prayer, I'd still like to invite you to our Alpha course. We're running it online in the evenings, and it begins on the 20th of April. The details, or more details, will be at the end of the service. It means you can do it in the comfort of your own home. It will give you the opportunity to ask questions about the Christian faith. It will give you the opportunity to examine the evidence for the resurrection, the greatest event in history. Amen. And so we say the creed together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And so we turn to prayer. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you promised through your Son, Jesus Christ, to hear us when we pray in faith. Strengthen Donald and John, our bishops, and all your church in the service of Christ, that those who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless and guide Elizabeth, our Queen. Give wisdom to all in authority, and direct this and every nation in the ways of justice and of peace, that we may honour one another and seek the common good. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give grace to us, our families and friends, and to all our neighbours, that we may serve Christ in one another and love as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. And have a few moments to name those you know to the Lord. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Hear us as we remember those who have died in the faith of Christ. According to your promises, and grant us with them a share in your eternal kingdom. And rejoicing in the fellowship of all your saints, we commend ourselves and the whole creation to your unfailing love. So we share communion together. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal Father. And in these days of Easter, to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell, and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise and opened to them the gates of eternal life. And so in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory. Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to a disciple, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, call to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory. We celebrate this memorial of our redemption. And as we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. So send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom, all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. And so we pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Amen. So it's now time to take our bread and then our wine. The body of Christ broken for you.
Amen. Amen. The body of Christ.
Amen. The blood of Christ shed for you.
The blood of Christ shed for you.
And so we pray. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Well, thank you so much for joining us this morning for this Easter Sunday service. Do keep in touch with us. Our details are coming up at the end of the service. We're still holding our Zoom coffee gathering times at 11 o'clock on Sunday morning. Again, the details are at the end of the service. Finally, just to say, because now our churches are starting to open for in-person worship on a Sunday morning, and that at the moment is predominantly traditional based worship, this is going to be the final online traditional service. We're going to continue with the other types of services for a while yet, but this will be the last traditional online service. We'll still send out the paper copy for those who can't access other types of services. So let's leave you with a final blessing. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. And have a very happy Easter day.